All right, let's get the rest of the stream going. Just take a moment. It's doing so stupid right now. Okay. Get back to what I was doing. Updating description. Stream health is not great. That's unfortunate. Okay, so we got that on. And there's my phone right next to the microphone. Let me fix that. Sorry. A little more setup here, real quick. Hey, Doc, welcome to the stream. So, that's how this is gonna work. This would be a good idea. I'm gonna go ahead and put my Google Doc on the description for the page. All right. So here is the plan, Stan. I have altered the description of the stream to include a link to the manual. I'm going to play, or attempt to play, Mega Schwarzschild for the Sega CD.
a Japanese space tactics game that is a lot of text and things. Now, to aid me in my quest, I have used a combination of my scanner and Google Translate to translate the manual into something that resembles English. I have also, ahead of time, gone through most of the menus in the main gameplay screen and using Google Translate in some context to deduce pretty much what the menus do, and I have that on a piece of notebook paper right next to me. So, we'll be playing the game. You may view my poorly translated manual, and as we stumble through, you can just kind of follow along with me and provide insight and tips, and we can have a discussion about what the hell I'm trying to do should we get stuck. Without further ado, Mega Schwarzschild.人類はその誕生以来、自ら引き起こした最悪により、滅亡の危機を幾度となく招き、その度に決して少なくはない犠牲を払い、滅亡という最悪の事態は免れてきた。彼らの文明は加速度的に進歩を遂げ、ついに宇宙への道が開かれた時、人類は席を切ったように宇宙へ流飛した。彼らの旅立つ先、大宇宙に光り輝く巨大な渦、大銀河シュバルツシルト。無限とも思われる歳月が人類を幾百億の惑星に根付かせ、幾百億の歴史を続かせた。地球の名が人類発祥の地という神秘のベールに飾られ、伝説上の存在となった今、たった一つの惑星にひしめき
No, I have not. All the audio is going to be in Japanese. I mean, I'm going to be able to probably play the game without translating any sort of voice. And that's my goal. First of all, just understand how the game works. I could try that at some later date. And essentially, all the audio for the cutscenes is part of the Redbook audio tracks. So you can technically rip the image, get the WAV files off, run them through some sort of translation software, and if you feel so inclined, attempt to dub stuff into the audio and then remaster the disc with that. That's a lot of work I'm not willing to do right this second. But I will settle for being able to play the game and understand the mechanics. You get some clues into the story from what I've translated from the manual. Get your classic universe at conflict. You play the role of a prince of a recently assassinated king who's back from study to presumably lead his democratic nation against the bad guys who are very conflict and war happy. Whereas you, being the peacemakers, are like, oh, I don't want to go to war, but if you can make me okay, we're going to go to war. We'll be the righteous warriors. And it looks like four of the generals are good guy generals. They're probably going to be with you throughout this campaign. Four of the generals are bad guy generals. Those are outlined in the latter half of the manual. And they both sets have their own sets of battleships. It looks like the bad guy ships tend to be a little bit stronger. That's about as much context as I have. And you can see, like, the cutscenes here give you a brief idea of all the major kinds of battles you go through. Get ship on ship, ship on planet, ship versus satellite. Schwarzschild.
I've also gone ahead and made enough room on my RAM to actually save the game. Now, I'm still going to run through the cinematics here, because I still find them kind of entertaining.
ソマリという名の政権が、この数十年、銀河中枢の争いに巻き込まれることもなく、平和な日々を送ってきたこの政権、今、戦いの火の手が上がろうとしていた。
隣国で起こった武力衝突の平和的解決に向けて、とある国王が仲介に立とうとした。しかし、その国王の治める国に突然反乱が起こり、一発の教団が国王と和平を亡き者にしてしまったのだ。突然国王を失った臨民たちの国はオーラクルムという。王には国元を離れ留学中であった皇太子に、
知らせを受けた皇太子は急に母国へと向かった。母上はいかがなさっておられる。あまりにも突然のご不幸、知らせをお聞きになるや伏せってしまわれたよし。医師どもは心配ないと申しておりますが、ご心中を察するとあまりにもお痛ましく。
決してお体の強い方ではないかな。みんな、和歌のお帰りをお待ち申しております。そうか。で、反乱がどうした？反乱の
首謀者は、第二艦隊のザルツ提督と思われますが、第三艦隊も支配下に置いているもようで。
第三艦隊？確か、ヒルデン大佐だったな。
はあ、ヒルデンはザルツの甥にあたります。 謀反人どもは国王陛下を暗殺に及ぶや惑星ナッソスを制圧して独立を宣言いたしました。独立の大義？誠にたわけた申し出で、独裁者からの解放と理想の新体制だと。誠にたわけた申し出で、
独裁者、我が父が
皆怒り狂っております。
一体どう捏造すれば国王陛下を独裁者などと言えるのか。新体制とは何を指しておる。あやつらの
背後にはロッサリアがおりますゆえ。軍事国家が理想の新体制なのか。 惑星ナッソスの住民も困惑しておる模様で、表立った意思表示はございませんが、すでに抵抗組織が全土で結成されております。反乱を起こすには策がなさすぎるな。はあ、ロッサリアとしては、トリスティア制圧の時間稼ぎに過ぎないのでは。しかも、国王陛下のお命が最大の目的だったのでしょう。
完全にやられたわけ。反乱軍相手で精一杯の我らがトリスティアの力になれるとは思えんが。で、戦況は？現在、
守勢中域で我が艦隊が反乱軍と睨み合っております。守勢中域？守勢アリウスを望むとは、あやつらも欲が深い。
全艦に通達。 本艦隊は至急本船に戻る。
御意。
父上。
Oh, this is such early 90s, late 80s anime sci-fi at its best. Love it.
惑星ナススを制圧した反乱軍は目下全艦隊を主星地域に展開させております。ただこのままアリウスに向かってくるのか、それとも第二惑星ポニオスをまず攻めるのか、作戦部でも意見が分かれるところで。
我が艦隊との戦力差は
やや我が方に不利かと。ただ首謀者と見られるザルス提督の姿が先日、惑星ナッサスの司令部で目撃されております。
ザルツはナッサスに残った。我が目標は惑星ナッサスか。
本星に戻り次第、即位の儀を執り行っていただきます。
王となるか。
西暦3960年3の月、オーラクルムは新たな王を迎えるのです。
いや、オーラクルムが迎えたのは平和の終わりだ。
So I believe that's going to take us to the battle scene proper now. There we are. So I think we'll have to confirm it, but I think right now the middle planet is neutral, the far left planet is enemy, and then ours is the one on the far right. Cracking out translate to see if I can get anything out of this text on the screen. So a challenge with translating anything off the television is the camera's rather sensitive to the blurriness of the composite signal, and some backgrounds it just does not register text for very well. I think it's just a lot of noise overall. Alright, so what she's saying. Communication comes from Admiral Rutz, the mastermind of His Majesty Rebellion. Probably His Majesty's Rebellion. Let's see if I get anything out of this. Something I find often is I don't get any Japanese detection a lot of the time when I'm on TV. I'll give it one more shot. Ah, of course. Yeah, it's not finding anything, so whatever. I'll try not to hang too long on the dialogues, because you lose a lot of time on this. Now, you see, those of you watching at home, if you know Japanese, I mean, save me some trouble. Alright, and then she says she'll be waiting, so I guess he's taking the call now, and here is our Admiral. I went through a little bit of this before, so I think he's pretty much like, don't try to stop me. I might translate only caught portions of this. That's what he's saying. Try one more time. What'd you say, this is Oratrix People's Liberation Council chairperson. He's introducing himself. And our hero says, oh, man, I almost know this got picked up. Try that one more time, this time with gusto. He's asking if the guys in, or let me say, is this the name of a rebel? He's saying, I want to tell you something, and I'm only going to tell you once, so listen well. He's commanding the royal family to abandon all its power and to transfer all national institutions to the People's Liberation Army, the rebels. Cede the main star Arius, which I believe is their main base, and put all its military power under command of the People's Liberation Army. If you do not obey these orders, People's Liberation Army, will show you its strength and destroy all hope of you evil hypocrites. Doing a little bit of interpretation in this. And our friend the hero responds with, try one more time, because that's a little bit silly sounding, and then I want to make sure I somewhat represent the spirit of this text. If this is what you wish. If this is what you wish, then we'll never give it to you. Your intimidating fear does not faze me. I'm gonna read this word for word because this sounds... Oh, you're gonna miss the final line though, Doc. I'm gonna wait for Chris to get back, as he's the only one watching, and frankly, come on, this is riveting stuff. The generals are exchanging words. Set up my pages in the manual for where I'm probably using most, which is the rules and the ship types. Stream health is still orange. It's rather unfortunate. Just waiting for Chris to come on back.
Thank you.
Come on, Doc. Come on back. Now, part of my stalling, too, is just because all I'm deciding the stream was so Chris could interact. So I don't really want to go too far without him around to experience the adventure.
Thank you.
Still waiting on Doc. It's been about 20 minutes. Right back is apparently an exaggeration. Alright, then we're just going to continue because this is getting ridiculous. So, we have the exchange going back and forth. This dude called in, essentially telling the main character, throw down your arms, give us everything. It's like, no, nah. This dude responds, it is strange that it is impossible to understand this reality. It is you who will regret. Pretty clear message from that. Let's see how this continues. Okay, and then start telling us the communication has ended and that now our first fleet commander is calling us. There he is. He's essentially calling the guy we just talked to a villain. He asks if the fleet commander is ready for combat. The commander says, leave it to me, we'll crush these rebels. Okay. So now we're being informed about the turn year, because the way we track turns in the game is the year is going to increment every round. So the current calendar year is 3960. Our revenue fund is 260, which I believe that's the amount of revenue we get every round. And our total fund amount is currently 410 units. And now we're into combat. So, I'm gonna grab my battery real quick. We got the setup, we know how much cash we got. Then we'll explain the game. Too bad Doc's not around. All right, so where we're at then with the game. We have a couple things going on here. Firstly, you can see in the lower right hand we have a mini map, and the you can see the white border on there kind of indicates your you know, kind of the screen's view. According to my translations of the description of the map, the brighter areas are planets and fleets. You know, for instance, you can see on the main map, the planet here is brighter than the other part. Same thing with that planet and that planet, and we got some fleets. It says bright is player-controlled area and dark is enemy-controlled area. I guess there's some truth to that. I think it would go more for a blue and red sort of thing. Squares on this are planets. Lines are fleets. Yeah, makes sense. Yellow is neutral and green is for allies. So this looks like it should be mine. And you see that planet has a little arrow on it. That means there's fleets there. So, that's kind of the lay of the land. You've got a menu that you get to by pressing... I can hit A, which I believe will go to my planet. That's true. B will open up our main system menu, and C on one of my ships will give me some information about them. Like, for instance, we go to the library. That's going to tell me that... I think that's... This represents a fleet of ships. There's three of them, and they're all at 100 strength. And just to make sure that kanji matches up with my manual. These should all be... Borrelet grade. Yep, they're all Borrelet grade. They all have 100 power. That all makes sense. So we have two sets of three. And then on my planet, what do I got here? Oh, last one here. So this is going to tell me a variety of things. I think part of what it does is gives you a description of the planet itself. I'm just going to tell me about this planet and see if I can discern any information from that. I mean, the lore of the planet's pretty cool, but I don't really need to know that to play. It's telling us that our first fleet of commanding forces are integrated there. What are these ratings? I think these are defense ratings. We have three defensive satellites. I think that's 200 defense. It's called... The planet is Arius. And it's one of... Orichrome, which I guess is our country. Yeah, Orichrome is our country. So that's our territory. So the first one is Orichrome territory, the second one is Planet Arius. And it has 200 defense and three satellites. Great. In addition to that, we can also, I believe there's ships parked there that we can look at. Yeah, so we have to go to Fleet Commands, which is the first one there. So the Fleet Commands, and you can see it has them lined up there at the top. You can see we have, our fleet has four Borlias class. We can also move them. And then just move them off the planet. And then there's also a planetary move which will actually warp them to a different planet. So we got those, we've got our ships. Let's see what's going on here. So I'm just looking up the description of this other planet, which I think is mine. It's a very bad translation. Bonios. This is planet Bonios. Okay. So defenses are thin because it's in the middle. It's the middle star planet of Aurochrome, which is our country. Fine. That's 24 defense and one satellite. Yep, one defensive satellite. 24 protection. Aurochrome territory. Planet Bonios. That's called Bonios. Hence, it's Bonios. Don't know if that if it's ours or not. We'll find out, I guess. One thing we can do too. We can save, which would be good, so I don't have to go through all of the. All the cinematics again. So bring up that, and I'll bring up our save menu. And it didn't jot down positive versus negative for the menu, so I gotta do the translate to actually see which one saves and which one doesn't. Learn the language, gang, that's the lesson here. Sick, you can pick up the text that was right in front of you. Okay, so top is a save. Slots, so let's just do slot zero. Let's see if I get lucky and just gonna have yes or no here. Well, it looks like hi. Yeah, so that's hi. I don't know what you're asking me, which makes this prompt hard, but I want to make sure I save correctly. Okay, what do we got?
Do you want to play the game with a demo? So then you ask me if I want to continue or not. It's confirming I was saved. See what that top option is. Game back and back. I think this will do the right thing. Is return the game? It is. Okay, we've saved, we've returned to the game. Great, we didn't F that up. Okay. That's a bit slow, and hopefully it'll get faster as we know what the hell we're doing. So anyway, now we've got our ships, got our basic menus, and we've saved. Now to experiment a little bit. We can move our ships. I think. Let me see real quick. Well, firstly, I remember before I moved, I thought I moved my ships. Next, I put them into combat. So I'm gonna look up real quick the rules of satellite combat, military combat, call the fighting of the fleets of the planet, warfare. Alright, so there's no orders given when we're doing planetary combat, great. So let's try moving. Saying. You're not helping me very much. Magic incantation of angle will actually cause, will translate to recognize this text. Whatever. C doesn't work. B, A. We're getting into combat? Is that what we're doing? I think it was riding ships. Oh, dang it. Come on, English. Flip that shit around. So, okay, those are rebel ships. I see now. So he's asking if he wants to attack them. Which I'm probably going to say, hell yes, attack them.
So that's the start attack up there at the top, and that's what we're going to want. So we're going to get ourselves into a fleet combat. Paused it. Okay. So now this is where things get interesting. Four mine versus three of theirs. Okay. This makes more sense now why attacks happened before. So there, what we see on the screen here is a lot of stuff. We've got the defending fleet at the bottom view, attacking fleet at the top, which is mine. That bottom fleet right now is in, I guess that'd be the C formation. So it's effective against the D formation. So I'm gonna get to the B formation. Okay. So now they're in what the hell formation is that? They're in the A formation, which is effective against B. Seems I want to get to the E formation. We did it! We won! How do you like that? How do you like that? Okay. So you can see what's basically happening then. So we're constantly shifting formations throughout the fight. And you're trying to keep yourself in a formation that is advantageous against your opponent. And for those of you that may or may not be looking at the manual I have linked, there's an entire flow chart for how it works, which is mimicked in that lower right hand for like which ones you can transition to. But mine has included what it's strong against. So we did that. I'm kind of proud of that. We actually won a fight. Good work. Next up, we need to build some more ships, probably. But let's do a couple things. First, let's devote some to asteroid exploration, which will give us more cash. And it asks how much we're going to put towards it. Make sure it's the right thing. I'm pretty sure it's asteroid exploration. The idea is if you do that successfully, then you get more cash per turn. Yes, yeah. Okay, so I thought I could choose, but apparently I can't. So we got asteroid exploration happening. We can repair. So we can't do any building. Okay, so I can't put any more towards that. Strength and defensive? That'd be this one. Okay, so I've moved, done that. I think I will end action, unless I can do something else, which I don't think I can. I mean, there's repair.
she asks him. Oh no, that's replay. So that's not repair, that's replay. That's replay episode. Good thing I didn't actually go through with that. Let me double check what I have in the manual. Saving, loading. No planet commands. Yeah, system commands. That's restart, sun. I ain't restarting. That's a bad translation. Okay. What's this dude? It's also three. What do I got? This is all a little bit dinged up. Hey Doc, you missed a lot, sort of. I waited for a bit and then just did stuff. Let's see what that is. So, essentially the rest of the dialogue for the combat. You know, good guy, bad guy, we're talking back and forth. Bad guy's like, throw down your arms, give me your planet. Now. Our hero's like, nah man, that ain't gonna happen. I think I still have the dialogue for what he said in return. Let me see. Yes. And then the guy goes, it is strange that it is impossible to understand this reality. It is you who will regret. And thus started the fight. Now, we're at a point where I had my first ship fight, because the guy had one ship parked right outside my planet. I managed to do some successful maneuvering of formations and blew him up. Now, I am looking to see what my next move is. Got a couple of things, possible options here for a ship. I'm not familiar with what these options are. These don't come up on my menus. So I want the top there is move. I think that one third from the top is repair. I guess that's supposed to be planetary. Oh, okay, so this is the same option. These are just the fleet options. Okay. So fourth down. Renovation and purchase. Okay. I think I can do that. I think I have to be parked at a planet to do that, so I can't actually do anything with them right now. I see that, okay. So essentially, before I was accessing the fleet menus from the planetary menu, I see that when they separate, essentially, the fleet menu separates, and then I get the fleet menu as a separate menu. And of course, it's enemy ship. So, I'm gonna action end. He's gonna try attacking these guys. There's not much I can do. Take him out! Come on! Take out that saddle, or take out the ships. Two left, come on.
fudge. They just took the planet. You know, his ass is parked there. I'm not thrilled about that. Can't do shipbuilding. I want that option down there, I don't have it. So maybe I have to do that next turn. I don't know what this is. What are they saying? Much additional budget amount fund, planned, should design. What's your imperial price? Okay, we'll do that. Let's see, what was that planet one I just did? That was research. So we just did more research. Can't do any fleet commands, really. Just did research. Do some asteroid exploration. I don't have enough money for that. So I can't do shipbuilding. Div is repair, right? Yeah, so it's all selected. What else do I have for options? Planetary move. Okay, he's in. Now we're doing some formation changes here. My guys are kind of beat up, and I was hoping that I'd get one more stab at not dying. So these guys are in C formation. So I'm going to get in B formation. So that guy's an E now. Come on, attack him. This is not looking good for me. Looks like they retreated. Okay. Why can't I do shipbuilding? These guys are all full strength. Great. Let's wipe the floor with these a-holes. Yeah. Sorry, I keep having to look this up. So they're going into A. So I'm going to make my way over to E. Those guys are now in some sort of triangular formation, so that's, I guess they're in B formation? Maybe? Anything effective against E, so maybe they're in D. Let's build up our defensive satellites. We got four satellites now. Four satellites this time. Turn. Okay. Parts, I think it's just part of the repair process. So they're in C. If they're in C, they're trying to hit D. So I can go to C. Those guys are going to A. These guys are going to B, I think. So they're going to B. It means I have to get to A. Let me see if they're A. Now they're shifting again back to B. We stay the course. Don't quite know how to do this. Let me see if I can get details on it. So refurbish and purchase. Which is this. You can only do when you're on a planet. Change the ability of the battleship or purchase consume parts to be mounted. So the ability to change the direction buttons up and down, then increase or decrease left and right. That's what I'm doing here. I see. So we can take stuff out of some and put it in the other. So you crew parts. Like that. Okay. Take it out of bomb. Because we're not attacking a planet right now. Still got repairs we can do. So I think these guys are getting better as they win fights, which is kind of interesting. Spend
think anyone has any spare parts. It's cannons. Yeah. So cannons are good against attacking other ships. Shipbuilding only when fleet on planet is sealed. So, okay, so you can use shipbuilding to refurbish an existing fleet. Interesting. Okay. Strategy here is I start in D. I'm gonna go to C again. And he's moving his way to A. He moved from A to what? B? So he's in B. Oh snap, we got ourselves a new ship! Oh shit! Who's that honky tonk over there? That would be the Grillet grade, which instead of having 100 power has 140 power. Oh shit! Oh shit! You didn't know! Well, you'd better call somebody! I don't have any spare parts necessarily. This is all Borlet grade, which is like your beginner level. Let's do some asteroid stuff. I will devote some money to that. Strengthen my planetary defense. Let's increase that budget, what do you say? Yup. He's got four ships, though. He's meeting some business. I took out two of his ships. Let's see, he's got two planets, which is means he's got extra income technically coming in. Oh, you see that? I can put some shields on there now. Oh my god. Oh my god. Don't need no bombs, I don't need my shields. So devastating. This is how. Yes, please, more asteroid exploration. Keep that.
I get a build? I think I'm already doing all my heals and stuff, right? They're all full up. I don't know if you knew it or not, but I'm the one who knocks. So we got the fleet commands, and I can move, planetary move, repair. I guess I can do the stats of them. Just for stats. The thing I don't know is how to build more ships. If I have to lose a ship and then I can start replacing them. Wait, no, that's shipbuilding, huh? Oh, yeah. I guess that just happened. Oh, they just have all the parts. They can do everything. My bad. This guy's gonna get frickin' wrecked. I found out how to build ships! Make sure I'm repairing that one. I think I am. Yeah. Oh, let's go. You do the same thing every time. I already know your moves. I know your moves! I upgraded my plant's defenses to max. Upgraded my satellites to max. Oh, they're just healed. Oh, okay. That's good. Oh, but I guess what I could do... Oh, I need just a little bit more money. Okay. Run, run, run! Make sure these guys are healed up first. Can't upgrade him this turn, I guess. She's probably giving me all sorts of useful information about these planets, and I'm just like, yep, cool, whatever. I'm on the wrong menu, that's why. Go to the upgrade refinement. He's got some big ships now. He's upgrading his ships too. We gotta start going on the offensive, otherwise we're never gonna get anywhere. He's in... Make sure I got that formation right, I might not. He's in A formation, yeah. Moving out of A formation into probably B. He's back in A. So I'm fighting it's a different kind of fight we got now. This is a fortified fight. There's a specific formation I use against fortified. I think. We'll go to B formation. I got A or C to choose from. Well, we're gonna see how this rides. Come on, boys, you can do it. Take that planet. I Iran. Saying my head ship had died. I've also got two fleets, which is unfair. I don't have two fleets. Has one satellite. They're in A. Yeah, so I'm gonna be... No, they're in B. Settled song and dance. Come on, boys. Did Jets get against this? It's fucking running. Guess I gotta go on heavy offensive if I'm gonna do this. Here we go. Well, here's hoping this works out. Nope, you gotta be on a planet for that to work out. Man, maybe I just took too long. He got that planet early, and that was a problem. Well, we got rid of their head ship, luckily. got three satellites. I feel like I'm in a bit of either a losing state or a stalemate. Not really sure which. Can't do any more upgrades. Just knocked out my lead ship right away. Maybe this will be it. Maybe what I'm supposed to do in the beginning is work my ship to the second planet and then build the defenses of the first one and put pressure on them that way. I might have also camped too long on my own planet when he was weaker than me. Everything is a little bit BS that he had two fleets to start with. I hope so. I hope his fleet's dead. I'm experimenting with moving my ships in the S, which isn't so much a good idea overall. No, he still has both of his fleets. Of course he does. Early. Actually, I want to do this. There's something I can do. G formation becomes disadvantageous when you oppose a fleet or a fortress. This formation is effective in planetary combat, so I'm gonna go to G. Come on, gang. Punch through. Keep going. You can do it. You pussy. God damn it. Problem is, if your head ship gets knocked out, then that's it. Thank you. All right. Have a good night, Doc. Facing that in the wrong formation, aren't I? Want to go B. See, we'll do it this time. Things aren't looking good for me. Jeez, I'm alright. No, things don't look good for me at all. I wish I could build another fleet. I just need another fleet. That's D formation, isn't it? Let's see what formation they're moving into. I assume they're moving into B. They're moving into A. Get in a G formation. Alright, if we're gonna do it, this is the time we're gonna do it. Come on, guys. Have it. Oh my goodness. Thank goodness we took it. Good work, gang. Do that right. They are in C formation. That would be in B. Crap. I'm an idiot. I'll lose because of this. Hang on. No, I don't want to leave B. Let's hope these defenses hold up, because I botched that. First of all, let's save it. Probably should have just charged up my fleet. Yeah, I know. Not doing our best. Thank you. I hate that I couldn't park there that turn and do anything useful. That sucks. No! I didn't do that. Cool. Come on, boys, take it! Thank goodness. Good fucking luck taking this, a-holes. Thank you. I need to get a run where I can get enough health that I can pull to them. I think I can do that. I must have do that and I got him. Man, it's a tough fight. Formation. This looks really bad for me. Just hang in there. You jerk. I'm gonna go to bed. So I guess thanks for watching. Well, I learned a thing or three, but man, this is a tight spot. Anyway, we might do this again. We'll see.